In this video, we're continuing on with the Operations with Scientific Notation worksheet on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. I'll have a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Picking up where we left off with number 11, I'm going to start by dividing 8.42 by 5. And I'm going to write 10 to the 3rd over 10 squared as 10 to the 3 minus 2, because remember, when exponents of the same base, when those quantities are divided, then you can subtract the exponents. So 8.42 divided by 5 is 1.684. And I'll multiply that by 10 to the 3 minus 2, which is 10 to the 1st. And that's my solution in number 11, because I only have one digit in the ones place, and that's what we need for scientific notation. Now number 12. I'll divide 8.9 by 8.4, and I'll multiply that quantity by 10 to the 6 minus 6, because 10 to the 6 divided by 10 to the 6 will be 10 to the 6 minus 6. So I'll have 8.9 divided by 8.4, which is 1.0595, which rounds to 1.06, and we're multiplying that by 10 to the 6 minus 6, which is 10 to the 0. And that's my solution number 12 in scientific notation. If you're confused on why I can subtract those exponents, remember the quotient rule under the laws of exponents. A to the x divided by a to the y is equivalent to a to the x minus y. So in this case, a is 10, and x and y are both 6. In number 13, I have 8.9 times 10 to the 5th, and that raised to the 4th. So remembering my power of a product rule, I'll have a times b. If I raise that to the x, that'll be a to the x times b to the x. But also, my power rule, if I have a to the x to the y, that'll be a to the x times y. So I'm going to start by distributing that exponent of 4 like in the first formula. So 8.9 to the 4th times 10 to the 5th to the 4th. 8.9 to the 4th is approximately 6,274. So 6,274 will get multiplied by 10 to the 5 times 4, multiplying those exponents because of that second formula. So now I'll have 6,274 times 10 to the 5 times 4, which is 10 to the 20th. Now I need to move the decimal place over 1, 2, 3 times to the left in order to write that number in scientific notation. So I'll have 6.274 times 10 to the positive 3 since I moved it to the left, and then I'm still multiplying that by 10 to the 20th. So that's 6.274 times 10 to the 3 plus 20, which 3 plus 20 is 23. 6.274 times 10 to the 23rd. And number 14, I'll distribute that exponent. So negative 6 will go to 4, and it will go to 10 to the negative 5th. So I'll have 4 to the negative 6th times 10 to the negative 5th to the negative 6th. 4 to the negative 6th is 0.0002441. And that will get multiplied by 10 to the negative 5 times negative 6. So I need to rewrite this number. So I'm going to move the decimal place over 1, 2, 3, 4 times to the right. So I'll have 2.441 times 10 to the negative 4th, since I've moved the decimal place 4 times to the right. And that will be multiplied by 10 to the negative 5 times negative 6 is positive 30. So now I'll have 2.441 times 10 to the negative 4th plus 30. So that will be 2.441 times 10 to the positive 26, since negative 4 plus 30 is 26. Now moving on to the second page, number 15. I'll have 6 to the 3rd. Times 10 to the negative 5 times 3 when I distribute that 3. 6 to the third is 216, and that will be multiplied by 10 to the negative 15th, since negative 5 times 3 is negative 15. Now I need to write 216 times 10 to the negative 15th in scientific notation, and I'm going to do that by moving my decimal place 2 times to the left. So I'll have 2.16 times 10 to the positive 2, since I moved that decimal place 2 times to the left, and that will get multiplied by 10 to the negative 15th. Now, because I'm multiplying quantities of the same base, I'll be able to add the exponents. So I'll have 2.16 times 10 to the 2 plus negative 15, which is negative 13. 2.16 times 10 to the negative 13th. In number 16, distributing that negative 6, I'll get 6.3 to the negative 6 times 10 to the 2 times negative 6. 6.3 to the negative 6 is 0.000015 and then approximately 99, since it's 993, but we would round to 99. And I'm going to be multiplying that by 10 to the 2 times negative 6, which is 10 to the negative 12th. So I'll have to move my decimal place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times to the right. So this is 1.599 times 10 to the negative 5th, since I moved it to the right, but I still have to multiply that by 10 to the negative 12th. So my final solution will be 1.599 times 10 to the negative 17th, since I will add those exponents together. Now, when you type in 6.3 to the negative 6 on your calculator, you will get 1.599 approximately, and then it will say e and then negative 5. Essentially, this e negative 5 is 10 to the negative 5th. So as opposed to writing out the decimal and then moving that over, your calculator gives you the scientific notation of that number if it's really large or if it's really small. So the scientific notation of that number was 1.599 times 10 to the negative 5th, but we still had to multiply that by 10 to the negative 12th. And that's how we got 1.599 times 10 to the negative 17th. In number 17, distributing my exponent of 2, I'll have 5.21 squared times 10 to the negative 5 times 2. 5.21 squared is 27.1441, which rounds to 27.14. And we're multiplying that by 10 to the negative 5 times 2, which is 10 to the negative 10. Now I need to move my decimal place over once to the left. So that will give me 2.714 times 10 to the positive 1, and then I'm going to be multiplying that by 10 to the negative 10th. So adding those exponents, I'll have 2.714 times 10 to the negative 9th. And that's my solution in number 17. In number 18, I'll have 2.4 to the 4th times 10 to the negative 5th times 4. 2.4 to the 4th is 33.1776, which rounds to 33.18. And that will be multiplied by 10 to the negative 20th. Negative 5 times 4 is negative 20. I'll move that decimal place over once to the left, so that I'll have 3.318 times 10 to the 1st times 10 to the negative 20th. So in scientific notation, that will be 3.318 times 10 to the 1 plus negative 20, which is negative 19. In number 19, I'll divide 3 by 8, and I'll multiply that by 10 to the negative 2 minus a negative 1. Because those quantities are divided and I have the same base, I will therefore subtract the exponents. 3 divided by 8 is 0.375, and I'm going to be multiplying that by 10 to the negative 2 minus negative 1, which is negative 2 plus 1, which is negative 1. Now I still need to move my decimal place over once to the right so that I have a single digit in my ones place. So that will be 3.75 times 10 to the negative 1, but I still have to multiply by 10 to the negative 1. So that's 3.75 times 10 to the negative 1 plus negative 1, which is negative 2. 3.75 times 10 to the negative 2. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 20. If you haven't done so already, remember to like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. So go ahead and do that now. Hopefully that you've done that, let's go over number 20. We'll take 4.1 and divide that by 1.28. And that will be multiplying by 10 to the 4 minus a negative 5. 4.1 divided by 1.28 is 3.203125, which rounds to 3.203. And that will be multiplied by 10 to the 4 minus negative 5, or 4 plus 5, which is 10 to the 9th. And that is the solution in number 20. If you have any questions, or just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below. Continue on to the next video, where I'll finish this worksheet completing numbers 21 through 28. And if you didn't do so before 20, like, subscribe, and share this video.